Hello, this is Sandra Hart. Welcome. Today, it's the power of emotions, feelings, and imagination. The sound of rain needs no translation, taking me far away in my imagination. A sky princess skips across each white puff, feather-like prints sending fine droplets to the earth below. Her prince, strong with desire, bounds the chase through the sky, strong heart and heavy steps shaking clouds who cry. Rain and passion come full force. The sound of rain needs no translation, taking me far away in my imagination. Hello, this is Sandra Hart. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining me at Purposeful Gatherings today. Today we're going to be talking about emotions and imagination. Now, how long has it been since you used your imagination? When you were a child? Do you use it now as an adult? Where most people would say, you know, it's been a long time since I've imagined a lot of stuff. So I would say it was a long time ago that I used my imagination. Well, do you know, we are very lucky because humans, you and I, we are the only ones who have the ability to imagine. Animals don't have that ability at all. They have an innate nature that is in their DNA, and they know how to hunt and they know how to figure out a lot of things, but they do not imagine. They don't have that ability. So let's not lose it and let's enjoy it because it's a special gift that we humans have. Now, imagination, well, I'll say we have actions. Let's say this. We have actions. We have two types of actions. We have a creative action, and a creative action is so easy for us when we're young children. It's so easy for us to pretend and do make-believe, pretend we're nurses, pretend that things are not real, but in our minds, they are absolutely real. So we are creating an out-of-this-world experience, something that's absolutely not real, but it is so real to us. And that is called creativity. We have created a world that doesn't exist yet. It may. We have created situations that don't exist yet, but may in the future. You never know. Now, the second way activity that we do would be reproductive. Now, we all do this. All of us, if we daydream, if we, you know, think about our past, if we think about things that actually happened, that we don't have to invent, that are actually a part of our memory. For instance, when I was a little girl, I used to love going to my grandpa's farm. And so many times, I remember those days and I recall in my mind and I recreate that world that really was, because I had so much fun with all of my cousins, running through the grass, lying in the hammock, riding on the wagon on top of a haystack with my grandfather's German Shepherd dog. So those are things that I did, an activity that I did that was reproductive. So we have two ways we can be active. We can do a creative way, which we do so well as children. And we have a reproductive that we do so well as adults. Those are the two ways that we can be active and do actions. Now, why is it that so many of us have grown up and we've lost so much of that imagination process and we haven't used it as much as we should when we do things? You know, Albert Einstein, and I'm going to have to read you this comment. Albert Einstein said, to stimulate creativity, one must develop the childlike inclination to play. And even Pablo Picasso said, every child is an artist. It's just too bad that we don't remember that as an adult. Because an artist, in order to create something that is not there yet, another inner world that hasn't been experienced or put on canvas, we have to use that imagination, don't we? So those are really two very important parts of our thinking process that are really important. And I want you to jot down in your workbook those games that you should used to play as children, and maybe how you think you might use that imagination today. I would say an example of imagination that all of us do, and we just catch it, is that when you're trying to think of something and you have that aha moment, when you say, oh, that's a great idea. Do you know what that is? You have created an out-of-the-world idea that hasn't been executed yet, but you have used that part of the creative part of your brain to come up with that idea, no matter what it is, no matter it's how to wrap a package, bake a cake, or to just, like me, doing what I'm doing here. You know, I'm taking a great big risk because I'm not sure how many people are really going to enjoy this process of getting into deeper conversations with one another and maybe learning more about each other and how to better use our lives, because very few people are doing it on YouTube, and I don't think anybody is doing it in the beauty community. So I really took a risk, but I felt that this was so important because sitting around here in this stay-in-place order, I mean, it really gets lonely. I mean, you know, you love your husband and you love your dogs, but you want to get out and interact with the human race because that is who we are. That's part of our DNA. You know, I always thought I was kind of a hermit, but now that I really am, I'm not. I really am not. I want to connect with you. I want to connect with human beings. So let's use that part of our thinking and our imagination, and let's try to strengthen it and bring it up a little bit. There is something else that's called executive function. Now, you would think children don't have that, they're too young, but they really do. Because let's say Johnny is pretending. He has a spoon, and he's pretending it's a car. So he has to really remember not to put that spoon in his mouth, because that spoon is his car. So he has to have the self discipline to remember that that is a car and to follow through on the process. So he has self-control not to put it in his mouth, and he has that conscious discipline to remember that it is a car. And when I was a little girl and I made clothespin dolls out of my grandma's clothespins that were wooden, I surely had to remember not to hang something with my grandma on the line, because that clothespin with the fabric wrapped around it and the little tie, that was my doll. She was a person. So I had to use some of my executive decision when I was a little girl, when I was a child just developing, in order to pretend. How about you? When you were little, what did you do? What games did you play? I mean, did you make mud pies? And you surely pretended those pies were chocolate pies or apple pies, but you had the self-discipline not to put in your mouth and eat it, because you knew that that really was not a pie, but you were pretending that it was a chocolate pie. So all of those things, they have found out that even children at that young do start to develop that executive part of their brain. And I'm sure that these will bring back memories to you a lot, because we used to do all kinds of pretend things. I know that when I was a little girl, I would ask all my friends, well, I had about two friends because we lived in a farm area and they were way up the road, but I'd ask them to come and then I'd write little plays. Of course, I always made myself the lead, you know, thinking about me. But we would have fun. We would do little plays together and just pretend that we were other people than we were, the little 6 and 7 year old girls that we were. So in the end, from all of this that the studies that have been for children and adults, knowing that the further we get away from childhood, the harder it is for us to learn to use our imagination. But they have found that using our imagination is so important in your everyday life. It's so important for making great decisions about your life. For instance, when I lost my husband, I found out he wasn't paying the taxes, he wasn't paying the mortgage, he wasn't paying anything. And all of a sudden, I had to come up with creative ways that I could satisfy all of my debt. So at that time, I was using my creative ideas, say, okay, this is reality. This is the reproductive part that I know is real and is happening and it's in my brain. But I want to use my creative part to try to be creative to get myself out of this horrible financial mess. Well, I was able to do that by being creative, and you can do it too in your life. And I want you to put down, I bet there are times when you have been in situations that you thought were just absolutely hopeless, there was no way out, whatever it was, but you had to be creative in order to get out of the situation and to heal it and make it whole and make it right again. So that is part of our childhood that we have brought with us. It just isn't an everyday part of our lives, but it should be. Each and every single day is an opportunity to use our imagination, to look up into the sky and imagine when you see fireflies that they are, you know, fairies flying around. Or when you see the stars, just imagine that maybe there are people up there looking down at us. Or when you look at the moon, do imagine that it is romantic. And the poem that I wrote at the beginning of this, I really was using my imagination. I was sitting up in the garden and looking at the sky. And I thought, you know, I'm going to be talking about imagination. What can I think about what I see up there? What can I imagine in my brain is going out there? And I thought about it and I didn't really have an answer. The next day, it's been so hot here. It's been like in the high 80s and 90s. That all of a sudden the skies opened and it just a little trickles came down. Then all of a sudden rain came down out of the skies and it was absolutely so wonderful. And I had that aha moment and I thought, that's it. I'm going to take my imagination and my happiness at seeing that rain that is reality. And I'm going to put my imagination with reality. And I'm going to write about why I think this rain is happening today. You're asking yourself, now, how can I think more like a kid? Well, I just showed you a little bit of how you can. But for instance, you're at home now in this stay-at-home situation and you have a meeting by Zoom with your business partners and it's been canceled. So what do you think as an adult? What am I going to do today? Who am I going to see? What am I going to do? You know, and you mull it around because you had definitely set out a whole block of time for this meeting and all of a sudden you're free. Now, I want you to add to that. I'm 7 years old and school has been canceled. Now, what are you going to do? What are you going to say yourself that's different as an adult than as a seven-year-old? Are you going to say, wow, you know, as a seven-year-old, I'm free. You know, maybe I'll go and I'll, you know, get out a game and I'm going to play, or maybe I'm going to, go outside and talk to a friend of mine. Well, he can't go outside today because of the stay-in-place order. But, you know, a child has a different, maybe a different needs and different excitement about having the full day. When you, if all of a sudden you're just, everything is just blocked in time as an adult, you do this, you do that, you do this at the same time, but all of a sudden you're free. You have a chance as an adult to think like a child and be more experimental in what you're going to do with your time, even at home. You're going to watch a movie, you're going to play, you're going to call a friend, you're going to, you know, have a, you know, complete spa day at the house. That's what I mean by doing that. Use your imagination. As if you, sometimes when you think about what it would be like when you were 5, 6, 7 years old, and that might be your solution. So today, I can use my imagination and pretend that I'm Charlize Theron and that Pierce Brosnan is taking me to the Oscars. How about that? I can sit and daydream and create that scenario, and it makes me kind of happy. All right, thank you so very much for joining me today. Our next video and our next session is on word and what words mean to us and how they can make us feel good, how they can hurt us, how they can be constructive and make us move forward in our life.
I have also started a private Facebook page, Purposeful Gatherings with Sandra, where we can privately discuss all types of issues. And right now I have on there a contest that's going up until this Thursday. We're going to be talking about hair, and I want you to post the prettiest hair photo that you have ever had done. I'm going to be giving an Amazon gift certificate to the winner, and it's just for fun. It's just a little contest that is for fun. So if you would like to join and you are on Facebook, join the private group, Purposeful Gatherings with Sandra.
So please put your comments below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's certainly, I'm taking a risk. It's way out of the box. Be kind to someone today. Call someone up. Make them feel better about their lives. And don't forget to share the love. And thank you so much. And I hope I see you for our next Purposeful Gathering. And we're going to be talking about words. And we're also going to be talking about some of the comments that you have put down under this video today. Take care. I love you all. We're all in this together. Thank you. Bye-bye.